the guy who played Johnny Fever on WKRP.
Yeah, we just got
that. Yeah, he's got life canceled.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying.
This month, how many celebrities have died this month? Oh my gosh, we've got.
There's been a few.
We've got Brad, you're backfeeding.
Meatloaf. We've got Bob Saget.
Betty White.
Betty White was technically last year, but not really. She was on the 30th. She was literally the last.
Hi,
day.
Shortcake. Are your innocent? 31st. Are your innocent ears burned up already?
There? Yes, Toxie is
toxic
here.
There?
Toxie. Yeah, it's Toxie, by the way.
Stay out of my head. Last Monday, every time I tried to think, I kept hearing your voice in my head all day. And then I finally got your head. And then I finally got you out of my
head. Mic's not on,
and then Acular popped into my head.
Is Toxie's mic on?
He's not got something on.
What do you mean?
There you are.
He didn't have it up to his mouth.
No, I am. It's fine.
No, you weren't.
They have it now.
Could you imagine hearing Toxic voice in your head all day long?
No, but I did that with Arthur one time.
I had
Arthur's voice as my thinking voice for a while, and I was laughing every time I thought of something because it was just funny.
Hey, Waffles. How you doing, Waffles? I see you running away, Waffles.
You know, since we've got the VR gang here.
Was in there.
What was that, Waffles?
Waffles, what was that?
I'm doing the goods, yes.
You're doing the goods?
I'm doing the goods.
You don't look like a waffle unless you're blueberry waffles. Are you blueberry waffles? I mean,
no, Google it. Blue waffle.
I'm blue waffle, you know.
Wait a minute.
Blue waffle. I remember what that was.
Oh,
gross.
Wow.
Let's go. I ruined childhood.
I totally missed it.
Hey, so, Shortcake, you can beat up Waffles because he's right there for the blue waffle.
Yeah, punch the blue waffle.
No, don't.
Since we're in VR chat,
I am good boy.
You're letting that go?
That's a sight to see.
Let me throw this out there so you guys can be in on this too.
Because I'm already kind of like, Twitch is already pretty available, and I get a lot of notifications from Twitch, like when Oni goes online or someone like that.
I still have the file.
Yeah, but I get the flip side of the argument. We can't play anything but like copyright-free music over there, which, you know, means there'll be no sing-alongs or anything like that.
Right.
No.
Oh, just because you just hit the button, bitch. I'm still looking at my mug over on Mixcloud.
Oh, man, I had Zoom said, hey, update me. I freaking updated it, and it broke Zoom.
Update.
And all the video broke. And I'm like, God damn it. And I went on the forums, and it's been broken for like 6 months. So I went back.
It's insane.
So I went back. I had to find an old version and roll back. So is this you, Campion? Is this you, Mr. Robot Guy?
Hey, look, the shirt doesn't appear on the video. What?
Is Campion not a robot? I mean, I showed him, but he's just showing up.
Well, that's a robot. Yeah, I just don't know if that's the Campion you're thinking about.
The Campion we know and love.
Campion, are you here?
He says in channel that it's him. Hey, Blue Waffle. Do you have a sibling named Waffle Stomp?
Oh god.
Really gross.
That's the pet. I don't know, man. I'm adopted. We will see.
Yeah, Shivas are nuts.
I wouldn't doubt it.
Oh my god.
Hi, Shortcake. Do you like when we talk dirty to you?
What? Oh my god. Shortcake, I'm sorry. Ignore him.
It's fine. I've had worse. Don't worry.
Oh my god. We're too wholesome for this.
Hi, Fred. Do you hate it when we talk clean to you?
Yes, I do. You dirty man.
Hi, Thea. Are you?
Only the good die young.
Who's a good boy?
Are you clean or dirty? Are you clean or dirty?
Who's a good boy?
Show us them paws, boy.
Oh, he showed us a butt.
Oh, he's giving me butt.
Show us that dirty ass.
Whoa.
Oh, come on. You saw that coming a mile away.
Oh, 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 oh. Look at this little. Yeah.
You're so tiny.
It's fine, puppy. Where's the ship?
It's such a tiny bean.
Where's the ship?
Every time I go on VR chat, you're sleeping.
I know. I've never seen him awake.
He does wake up. He does sometimes. Have. He talks. He's not snoring. Yeah. He's not drooling on the.
He's either drinking vast amounts of alcohol or he's asleep. I've never seen him in early. Those are his two states of being.
Aww. Tired pupper.
Okay, we'll let those two have some private time. And what do we have here? We have the Goblin Hut. Hello, Wagon.
Hey.
Hi, Dwagon.
Good. I found my account.
How you doing, Dwagon?
Everyone's tiny at the Tiny Show today.
What brings you here?
Tiny Squad.
I can usually come in here as different avatar.
Ah. I don't recognize the name because you're not friends. You're not friends with us, so. Oop, you disappeared.
I tried to befriend you once.
Oh.
Oh, denied.
Where is he? Oh, he's
Oh God, it's a good boy. Oh no,
best boy.
Oh God, those monsters! They have no eyes.
I have a best buy, a best buy, a best boy. But
you have a best buy. Wait, hang on. There's a best buy nearby.
I have a best buy that is got eyes.
Whose eyes did you steal?
What those eyes remind me of is back in my days when I worked for Freddy Fazbear's.
Oh my God!
And the animatronics would have a little bit of a breakdown.
You really just say Freddy Fazbear's?
Yes. When the eyeballs that were inside the heads of the in the animatronics were balls, but sometimes the little shaft that they were on, the set screw would come loose, so the eyeball would turn around in the head and stare at its brain. And you would get that full white eye because there wasn't an iris on the other side or a pupil on the other side of the eyeball. So if the eyes spun around in the head, you would get the white eyes like that.
Well, yeah, that's exactly. I mean, that's almost
identical. So he's probably got pupils, but they're probably looking at his brain right now.
He's just ignoring us. This is like, you know, fuck these guys.
Yeah, but he's our buddy.
Look at my brain.
Nope.
No, he's our buddy.
I changed my VRC price to a different picture. To my Twitch photo.
Picture.
See, he's got white eyes up there too.
Yeah, know. even his main avatar has got white eyes.
Even his main avatar is blind.
It's zombie eyes.
He's looking into your soul.
That's very bad cataracts.
Yeah, he's looking into
they
your soul.
Had surgery blind. For that.
Very bad cat.
You guys are making nice. Fun of a blind man. You guys are shame on you.
Hola, ¿cómo está?
Oh, it's the sexy bear.
Yeah.
Hola.
Hola.
I am Goo.
Hello. Muy frío. Estoy muy frío.
Muy, lots of Fritos?
Aquí estoy muy caliente.
Lucky.
I sent messages about my issue on my computer. I'm on my mom's laptop.
I don't know if
he's
lucky or not. Because we have
late last night, so and then I was trying to get sleep for work today, and I ended up having to call in because I couldn't get enough sleep for work.
Well.
Brian Puppy's playing hooky. Is he playing bookie? You playing hooky?
Oh, someone got in trouble.
Hey, I got someone. I'm going to cover my shift. I got someone to cover my shift. I'm good.
So irresponsible.
So, Shortcake, we don't know. What do you do for a living?
I can't drive. I don't have a job.
Okay.
I don't drive.
So what's your plan? Do you plan on getting a car?
Probably my...
Well, because my anxiety disorder, it'd be hard for me to drive.
We all have anxiety here too. Don't worry.
Oh God!
Why?
Why? Why? My God! No! Get rid of that! No!
It looks like one of those squeaky toys we you squeezed it for too long, and his eyes are pulled together with skull.
He's a character from Animal Crossing. He's an Animal Crossing.
Where did even use your spells? Kill it.
Isn't he an Animal Crossing?
No, that is not Animal Crossing.
There's a medical condition.
El Dorado's got a complex. He says it's cute.
Look at the poor guy. He's so he's always picking on.
Someone squeezed his middle until everything came on the top and connected to
There's a medical condition. This is a medical condition.
Brain is trying to explode.
Fred.
Burn him.
I think that's what happened.
The eyes are like, I mean, he's got like hamster eyes.
Fur demons. Putting magic on those eyes.
Somebody give this. Somebody give this guy a public avatar.
Oh, you fixed it.
Oh, he's changing.
Wait, fur demon's magic.
Oh, he's gonna be a hot dog.
Fur demon, what have you turned him into?
The magic of friendship will make you look better.
Oh, now at least he looks yummy.
Now unleash the spell chaos.
Because me and a couple other people.
Contact Weeder. The other one.
Shortcake. Would you like a wiener?
No.
Well, that kind of wiener, yeah.
She wants a hot dog.
Depends on what kind of unleash chaos. There we go. That's the one.
Here, I'll get something for him. Hold on.
Oh, the Tatum. Oh, yeah, the Tatum. The Tatum dog is cute.
You can do it. I believe in you, Fur Demon.
You found a Tatum room the other day. Does he know about the Tatum room?
I don't know. I totally stumbled across the Tatum room. But they changed. I tried to get the new Tatum 2.0, but oh my god, the whole texture map is different.
It should be the trigger.
Oh, Bungie's got that pizza raccoon.
Yeah.
Here, clone this.
What's the pizza you got, Bungie? What's your pizza?
Fill the world with chaos! Clone this.
Hi, Coaster.
Hey, Coaster.
Clone this.
Yes, delicious chaos spreading across the world.
Hi, Lorik. How you doing? Yeah, how you doing?
Yeah, turn around. I want to look at my handiwork. Damn it.
So, Fur Demon, are you happy with your avatar?
Brian,
yes, Brian, that's a nod of yes.
Yes, that one. Use that spell and hold it up here.
Is that
the point?
Yeah.
Ah, that's a fire.
Do I hear a sherbert?
No.
We got more hot dog.
Everybody's turning into hot dog Tatums.
Hot dog Tatums.
Hot dog.
Bees. I'm a tasty sausage.
Small bees.
Wait, small.
Are you stealing it?
Okay.
Oh, I can't from that one.
Yes.
Make your Tatum dog stealable.
Oh, there you go. Yes.
Turn to a birdie.
And waffles. Hey, waffles again.
Okay, there we go.
He's a yellow waffle now.
My headset's messing up.
Is that a blue waffle?
I'm a bee.
Whoa.
What happened to Theo? What's going on? Why is everybody becoming a hot dog guy?
Because hot dogs are tasty.
Now eat them.
Biggity dog.
This reminds me of something that I like from Forest.
So as we try to come up with some fun ideas for games tonight, if someone in our Mixcloud chat wants to help come up with some questions, we would like to play the lying game, which is basically three facts about something or someone and one lie. And we have to guess that lie. So if anybody in the Mixcloud wants to have some fun and put together some questions, we will be more than happy to play it with our group.
Looks like
I didn't get the chance.
Campion's changing again. Oh, Campion disappeared. He poofed.
I look delicious.
Yes, you do.
I think he was his. That was his first day in VR chat. He's just learning.
I like that the hot dog Tatums have got the grill marks.
Oh, banana bread. Oh, give me banana bread.
It's not banana bread.
Is that not banana bread?
I like banana bread.
That better be zucchini bread or you're going to get thrown across the world.
Please, banana bread.
I had chocolate bread for lunch today.
Yeah, here. There we go.
Yeah, that looks like banana bread.
Chocolate bread?
Kill him.
Ha, Brian Puppy's got it in his mouth.
Vegemite!
He's
got bread in his mouth.
Oh my god, why do you have Vegemite?
He comes from a land down under.
Because it's tasty.
Okay, that's pretty cute.
Now she's a massive piece of banana.
That's mighty cute. That's a very impressive piece of banana bread, actually. It looks really delicious.
It looks pretty good.
He's floating in bread. He's trying to keep from drowning in his bread. He's got to stretch way tall. He's like he's in bed. He's sleeping in a little banana bread loaf.
Yes.
Oh god, Coast just broke his spine!
Oh no!
He's doing kidney exercises. He's doing his kidney stretches.
Oh my god! Oh!
Okay.
He's doing his kidney stretches.
You okay there, hon?
Yeah, that's where he touches his kidneys.
Yeah, sometimes the avatars go into these wacky positions, and they look like something out of Evil Dead.
His kidneys, I'm scared.
Yeah. Me too.
Boy, Brian really loves that Vegemite.
Eat it.
Sucking at Vegemite.
Brian,
yeah, I mean, if you're holding a piece of bread in your mouth that long, it's gonna just disintegrate.
I would just eat it. I couldn't do it.
I'm like, I don't know how to eat you.
Well, hey, I mean, Scar's here. Hey, Scar.
Come on.
Where's
really?
The milk coming from? Oh, okay.
Give me some milk. Pay the invasion.
What's the label?
Oh,
yeah, the label.
The milk would not go well with...
Oh, can we read that? Hold on.
No, it's kind of hard to read.
I can kind of make out some words. Hold on.
Raw nuzzles, how are you? Pounces on you.
Oh, my god,
you're
yes.
So warm. Oh. Notices you have a bulge. Someone's happy. God.
It's like a sex story going on.
And they wonder why the public
and he was trying to teabag and bit him.
Hi, Mutt.
Probably. Hi there.
Hi, Mutt. Mutt.
Hi, Mutt. Mutt.
Mutt. Mutt.
We're gonna play a game, and hopefully one of our friends in the Mixcloud chat are coming up with some questions. Again, we are looking for a series of questions that are three truths and a lie about. It could be about yourself. It could be about a celebrity that you researched. Three truths and a lie, and we're going to play that game later on tonight. So you don't have to come up with all the questions. Just come up with one, and we will play it. But be available, because we need you to tell us what the answer is. And we will play along, too, because these are fun things to do. They're games. I'm glad to...
All the money you would have gotten from the views goes to the artist.
Oh, my God. What is that?
That's a
bunny.
Campion found himself a bunny.
Campion, look at you!
Oh, my God.
Well,
it
that's
looks like a like what's
that's
oh
the
God.
Bunny from Spyro the Dragon.
Yay.
Oh, I was gonna say from it almost looks like the female one from Looney Tunes, but just wrong.
But now I'm not gonna friend him yet because I can see he's using a Steam name, and then once he figures out how to do VR chat a little bit more, he'll get his VR chat name. So he's probably on a straight up learning curve trying to figure this out right now.
Oh, it's so cute. It's
in fact,
noob.
It looks like he doesn't even know how to move.
Are you on desktop or you have a system?
Oh, yeah, it's desktop. That's
it
desktop.
Desktop.
Yeah,
okay.
Desktop. You can see because his hands are fused to his hips.
He's desktop. Yes.
He's probably nowhere near the camera.
How
right now.
How do you identify? What's your pronouns?
I don't even think he has a mic hooked up. I think he's mute.
Do you have, what's your pronouns? Is it?
I identify as a bunny.
As bunny?
Oh, yay,
so
bunny!
If I say, hey, bunny, I don't say he or she, I say bunny.
Yeah, bunny.
Okay, bunny. Well, we had that today at a restaurant problem.
And I want my
where
litter box in the bathroom.
We had our wait person, and I was like,
he wants a litter box in the bathroom so
oh,
he can put
yeah.
his pellets in it.
You called that guy a woman.
I still think
like,
it was a woman.
Was
I still think
woman.
It was a woman.
Not a woman.
They did not say anything. He, it was
his eyes like did that thing where
no,
like, oh.
the hair was all girly and boobies.
Nope.
But
no,
how should?
You
what's the safe
King
way?
Ralph with the princess that had the really deep
what's
voice.
What's the safe word?
What's the proper way to address a wait person if you don't know what their
you just don't
sexuality
use the name
is?
And you don't use the sex. You just say, excuse me.
Excuse me. I could be talking to anybody. I could be talking
you know,
to the table next to me.
They're going to
looks,
have to.
Go.
They're going to have to. You know, we lost the proper familiar. Variations in English, like around the turn of last century.
Yeah.
The these, thous, thine, that's kind of words.
Yeah.
And I can see it now that the English language is going to take a shift that you don't talk about people in any gender. So
I'm okay with this, and let's do that with a lot of separation terms. Let's kind of unite them together.
So
I'm
yeah,
kind of okay with this.
You know, it won't be his. But the problem is you know, it won't be his house or
her house.
It would have to be their house.
Right, but how do I? Excuse me.
It's house.
Excuse me there. Excuse me there. Can I please get some more milk or some more water?
No, you would just say excuse me.
Excuse me there.
No, you don't have to say it. You say no.
I don't have to say excuse me there.
Wow. Okay.
Make sure you use the correct spelling too.
You are cute.
You're right. Well, that's the fox as a wolf.
Oh yeah, it is. It is similar.
Yeah. Oh boy. Chanel, I'll just let you know. Yappy is now crushing on you. Yappy's now crushing.
No, I'm waiting for my new. I'm waiting for my boyfriend to show up.
Who is that now?
Oh, the dancing wolf.
Artie werewolf.
We'll page him in. Where's he at? Is he on?
I don't know.
Oh, is that Rigel? I thought I saw Rigel for a second. Is that him on the couch?
Is Rigel here?
I don't know. Oh, that might just be bad.
I ran into Rigel quickly last night.
He was.
Oh, Rigel was here?
He was in, he's out.
He was.
Yeah, it's that Artie werewolf guy. He's cute as hell.
Does he make you feel funny?
Oh, yeah.
Oh.
Wow.
I thought he was adorable, but I wasn't getting funny feeling.
Now is that becoming a bad thing to do these days?
Yes.
It's like how are people ever going to expect to have any form of
Thank you, Rocket T Coyote, for sending in your wonderful videos. We love them so much.
Everybody's staring at the screen.
It's like
Fred.
They're at a sleepover.
Fred's over there, like staring at everybody in the room. So
it's
he's
so strange seeing the Chaos Lounge behaving.
Well, they're all chilling. Look at the coaster's just kind of chilling out. He's relaxed. We gotta get some blankets for the ground.
Just totally relax.
Yeah, can we get some blankets?
Totally relax.
Or at least shag carpeting. Yeah, it's like some doggy beds.
All right, I'm getting some questions together.
Oh, is it almost game time?
Well, Fred, this is for the after 9 o'clock one.
And by the way, you know what happens next week, right?
What?
What?
The return of Punxsutawney Phil.
Oh, Groundhog's Day is coming. Okay. So do you watch Groundhog's Day with Bill Murray on Groundhog's Day?
I can't stand that movie.
You used to love that movie.
How the hell do you know I like that movie?
Because you told me over and over again you liked that movie. You watched it like 40 times.
No, it was because that was all HBO was playing.
Oh, that's why you watched it. I thought you liked it.
Oh, back in the old days of HBO when you run like Aliens five
it was
times
like,
a day.
Yeah, it was like I had just gotten cable TV for the first time in my life was when I moved out onto my own. So I'm like, oh, HBO, something I never had in my life. So I turn it on, and it's just back-to-back Groundhog's Day. Like, Weekend at Bernie's. That was the other one.
Yep, they ran the hell out. You know one they ran the hell out of that Mutt hates? What? The Water Babies. You could see that five times a day.
One of those.
Hated that film.
I would always get, like we'd be watching a movie, and my parents are in the room. And then suddenly something like adult happens, like a movie shows up. I would get like chased out of the room. Go to your room! Like I was in trouble. I'm like, what did I do? Every single time.
That was Beethoven's Third. Next up, Alien. They really didn't know how to run those things.
It's probably why I'm scared of women now. If I see a booty, I'm gonna yell at.
They seem to do that.
Well, negative reinforcement will do that.
Scarred as a child.
It's like, okay, I'll go play with my penis.
If every time you see a booby, you get tased, it's like.
An animated movie, and instantly after a suicide squad.
Yeah, my dad would take a tube out of the TV, and we couldn't watch the blue movies at night.
And next is another animated movie or family movie.
Wow, a tube TV.
Tubes, baby, tubes.
That inspired by the song by Aqua. So, this is going to be a bunch of different topics about the 1980s, various things, and you need to put the four square floor, the ABCD floor down.
Anybody can put the ABCD floor down? I don't even remember what part it is. No, I was just saying.
Here it is. That's the one.
I'm gonna move over here.
Okay, and Well, don't, if you know it in the studio, don't like scream it right away. But if you say you know, just say, hey, I know. And then you can answer after we get some input from our folks in the Chaos Lounge. All right.
So here. My husband. I'm here.
Oh, hello, hon.
No,
yeah, she's in VR.
Hey, Babs.
Where?
Over here, Babs. Here's the camera.
Over by the
Babs, camera right here.
Babs, how you feeling? How you feeling?
Oh, hey.
How you doing?
Hey. I'm feeling a lot better.
Good.
Fine.
You shoot out all those rocks like a gun?
So I'm not going to be waving or anything.
You shoot out all those rocks like bullets out of a gun?
I hope so. Now I'm feeling kind of funky on my left side, so I'm like, okay. Yeah, they shot it all off. It was like a game of asteroids inside of me. It's
game of asteroids. Nice.
All right. Well, Babs, you can play along with this little game
wow.
as well.
Out of context.
No, it works. Go. We're in context.
Okay.
I'm so glad you're feeling better, and I'm glad you're up and around. Yeah. Well, kind of.
All right.
Good to see you, sweetie.
Oh, my God. So am I. That was... Oh. Thanks, all sweetie. Right. Do you like my new avatar? I don't think you ever seen it.
I adore it. I adore it. But
it's
you're naked.
Pink.
We love it. We're about to play a game. Would you like to play along?
Please play along.
Yes, I would. Yes. Okay. What do I do? Do I still stare at the camera, right. or am I on?
No. You're going to stand on one of the four squares. Okay. I'm going to ask you a question and give you four options. You will need to identify which answer is correct. First question. These are about popular brands from the 1980s. Brand number one. What product? What product was having you ask them to take you away? What product would have you take it away? Was it A, American Express? A, American Express, B, Calgon, C, Greyhound, or D, Nescafe? What could it be?
Yeah,
you go
this.
Stand on the square.
Yeah, you go stand on the square of the one that you think it is.
Yeah, I did. I'm on the square.
Orange County Penitentiary.
Yeah, B.
Now you are.
Oh, take me away.
All right. Looks like almost everybody thinks Calgon if you say Nescafe. And the answer is Calgon. Calgon, take me away. Here's question number two. What kind of coffee was known to be good to the last drop? Was it A, Sanka? B, Taster's Choice? No, B, Taster's Choice. I'm sorry. C, Maxwell House? Or D, Folgers? A, Sanka, B, Taster's Choice, C, Maxwell House, D, Folgers.
Yeah.
It was good to the last drop.
I grew up at that time.
I'm on C. Yeah.
You're on C, okay. So it looks like we have one person that might be still on B, Taster's Choice. A lot of people on C, Maxwell House.
A lot of people in Mixcloud are saying C.
Yep, the answer is C, Maxwell House.
Good job, everybody.
All right, question number three.
Nice. I didn't drink a lot of coffee.
This one might be a little trickier.
I don't know American brands.
Which of the following was not one of the Rubik's toys? Which one was not a Rubik's toy? Was it A, the missing link? B, the snake? C, the pyramid? Or D, the magic? Which one? Three of them were Rubik's toys, one was not. Which one was not a Rubik's toy? Yeah, the missing link.
A missing link? I'm going to go to this one.
Okay, missing link. The snake is B, C is Pyraminx, and D is magic. All right, looks like almost a lot of people in the Chaos Lounge are saying A, missing link.
Yep, Mixcloud saying A and D.
A and D, and then nobody, not that many, I don't see anybody in Rubik's Snake. C, Pyraminx, got a couple people. D, the magic. The answer is actually C, the Pyraminx. The Rubik's Link, the Rubik's Snake, and the Rubik's Magic were all 80s toys.
Wow, go Bungie, go Bungie.
The Pyraminx,
really?
Yep, Pyraminx was made by Tomy. Yep, it was made by Tomy. It was not part of the Rubik's family, but it looked like one.
And I love the Pyraminx.
You know, I should have asked KT about this. I know he'd know. I thought the missing link was like a... I didn't know that was a Rubik's toy. That's the only one I ever saw.
Yep, there's one of the ones with the little chains on it.
The cube.
Yeah. All right. Question number four.
I didn't know they made other toys.
Yeah. Which of these products invited you to kiss a little longer? To kiss a little longer. Was it A, Listerine?
Ecstasy.
B, oh, I know.
B, Chapstick. C, Binaca. Or D, Big Red. A, Listerine. Oh. B, Chapstick. C, Binaca. Or D, Big Red.
Or E, Ecstasy.
All right. Looks like someone in the channel is saying Listerine.
Oh my god!
Almost everybody else is saying Big Red.
Thanks a lot.
What do we have in the What do we have in the channel? In the chat?
Channel saying D D D D D D D D D D D D D and B. One from Mephitis.
One B. It is. It is D D D D D. It's Big Red.
They want you to.
Yeah, kiss a little longer with Big Red. Okay.
Make love a little longer. Is that how it went?
That's exactly it. Kiss a little longer.
Deep throat a little longer.
Where did Clara Peller find the answer to where's the beef? Nice. Was it A,
Wendy's.
Burger King? Was it B, Arby's? Was it C, Wendy's? Or D, Chick-fil-A?
I think it was Arby's.
Yeah, I think it is Arby's.
Where's the beef? Was it A, Burger King? B, Arby's? C, Wendy's? Or D, Chick-fil-A?
Or E, Enzyte?
All right, what does the channel have to say?
A lot of C's.
Okay. We have some people saying in the KS line saying Burger King. A bunch of people saying Arby's. A few people saying Wendy's. Nobody's saying Chick-fil-A. The answer is C, Wendy's.
Where's the beef?
Where's the beef? That little tiny thing.
Where is the beef? Do we ever find that beef?
I was standing on the Wendy's side. I thought it Wendy's was beef.
Yeah, it was.
Kind of right.
Yeah. All right. What company would you go to if it absolutely, positively has to be there overnight?
McDonald's.
Grindr.
Was it A, DHL? B, Federal Express? C, Grindr. Western Union? Or D, UPS?
Or E, Booty Call?
Boy, these are getting rough.
Yeah, B, get in here. Your boyfriend's in the chat. Yeah, B, get in here. Your boyfriend just showed up in the lounge.
All right, it looks like a lot of people in the Chaos Lounge say Federal Express, a few people saying UPS. What do they say in the channel?
It's pretty much FedEx. UPS.
It was FedEx. When FedEx absolutely positively had to be there overnight.
He's off to the side.
All right, this is probably going to be very easy. If you dare wear short shorts, what product would you need to use? Was it A, Shower to Shower? B, Summer's Eve? D, oh my goodness. D, Nair? Or C, okay, hold on. Is it A, Shower to Shower? B, Summer's Eve? C, Nair? Or D, Flicker Razors?
Or E, Weed Whacker?
Probably guess this one.
I'm not sure.
If you dare to wear short shorts.
Yeah, I'm just following people.
I don't know.
Who remembers the leg?
But these are getting steadily harder.
Just a bit.
Yeah.
All right.
Yeah,
it looks like we have a few people saying D, Flicker Razors. That's the pink razor that was like circular. A lot of people saying C, Nair. I can't see if anybody's saying A or B. What are they saying in the chat?
They're actually not replying unless I got to refresh my chat here. Hold on. I might have to refresh.
A lot of people are saying C or Nair.
Ajax says C, and Captain Rue says Nair.
Well, they are all right. It is Nair. They would whistle and say, if you dare wear short shorts, Nair for short shorts. All right.
Nair.
Wear short shorts.
Now, what would you spread on your...
wear short shorts.
What would you spread on your toast if it's not nice to fool Mother Nature?
Blood.
It's not nice to fool Mother Nature, but what do you spread on your toast?
I can't believe it's not butter.
I can't believe it's not blood.
Was it A, parquet? B, I can't believe it's not butter. C, chiffon. Or D, imperial.
Did you just ruin the answer?
No, it's not the right answer.
I trust you.
Okay, now we got a little bit of a Chaos Lounge kind of split on this one. Got people running around all over the place. These are all brands. These are all products. Quite a few people saying B. I can't believe it's not butter. A couple of people saying C, chiffon. Nobody's saying D, imperial. With a little crown on it. And what does our channel have to say?
Channel saying B, D, and C, C. Riskier says A. Zapper says B. T'Chol and Rocket say C. Mephitis and Wheelie say D. And
Right.
Ajax says A over blood says B.
And the answer actually is C, chiffon. If it tastes like butter, but it's not, it's chiffon. And it's not nice to fool Mother Nature.
It's chiffon.
It's chiffon.
Yeah, all Mother right. Nature was pissed at this butter.
Oh, she got mad.
Right. She like destroyed people. She canceled everybody.
No, parquet was. Is it butter? Butter?
So. Well, parquet was the talking butter tube.
Yeah. I just don't remember what it was for.
Right. So
and no
nine.
One was freaked out by the talking butter, by the way. It's just
oh,
like,
I was.
No, I mean, it's like I'm not tripping balls right now. The butter's yeah. talking to me.
They freaked me out big time. All right. Which of the following gave you the ultimate bubble with the ultimate flavor? Was it A, Hubba Bubba Bubblegum, B, Bubblicious,
yep.
C, Bazooka, or D, Big League Chewing Gum?
I was just
gum?
About to say Big League.
A, Hubba Bubba Bubblegum. I just love saying
that. Big League when you B, hit the perfect game.
B, Bubblicious, C, Bazooka, or D, Big League Chewing Gum?
I tried Big League Chewing and I wasn't that impressed. I was like, this is just bubblegum.
That good.
I was like, this is just bubblegum.
We have a lot of people saying Hubba Bubba Bubblegum, and a few people saying Bubblicious, a couple people saying Bazooka. What does our channel have to say?
Everyone say Hubba Bubba Bubblegum.
All right. Well, actually, the few people that are standing on Bubblicious are correct. Yeah, it was Bubblicious, the ultimate bubble with the ultimate flavor. And it had people flying around in space.
But you get half a point if you said Hubba Bubba Bubble Gum.
Yeah, if you said Hubba Bubba Bubble Gum, you just made
me smile. Never heard of it.
All right. Which of the following candy bars used the slogan, whatever it is? Whatever it is. Was it A, the Whatchamacallit?
Oh, I know this
B,
one.
B, Puffalumps. Yes. I mean, C, me. Razzles. Or D, Bonkers. Was it A, whatchamacallit, B, Puffalumps, C, Razzles, and D, Bonkers? And yes, these are all actual real candies. Oh, we lost the floor.
Oh, we lost the floor! Perko! Someone put it back!
Puffalumps wasn't
Thank you,
candy.
Coaster.
That was a stuffed toy line.
Nope, it's a candy. There was a candy in the 80s called Puffalumps.
There was.
Yep, Puffalumps. All right.
Sounds like it's
a lot of
Winnie the Pooh.
A lot of people saying A.
The toys.
Yeah, a lot of people saying A, whatchamacallit. A few people saying D, Bonkers. What does our chat have to say, Poink?
They are saying they love whatchamacallits and Razzles and Toffee Fay and AACAD.
All right. Well, it is whatchamacallit. That was actually our tagline. You will love it, whatever it is.
Hi, Zelno.
All right.
Not even sure they make those anymore.
Yep. Now, the next part of this are TV show theme songs from the 80s. Going to give you some lyrics. You have to guess which show they come from. What TV show started with, I guess we've been together for a million years? Was it A, Too Close for Comfort? B, Night Court? C, Family Ties? Or D, MacGyver? I guess we've been together for a million
Let's
years.
Say Quantum Leap, because that line sounds like a Quantum Leap thing.
All right. Hello. So A, Too Close for Comfort. Hello. B, Night Court. C, Family Ties. D, MacGyver. Okay, we got a big split in the chaos between Too Close for Comfort and Family Ties.
Secret says C, but I think it's because it begins with C for Secret.
And MacGyver has a couple votes at the Chaos Lounge.
Overblood says A. Ajax and Rescuer say C.
All right. Well, those who voted C are correct. It was Family Ties with Michael J. Fox.
Yeah. Ox says Family Ties and Rocky says A.
All right. Now, what TV show's opening sequence started with a shadowy flight into the world of a man who does not exist? Was it A, Automan, B,
what?
Knight Rider,
oh, Matilda can tell me
C,
this one.
C, the A-Team, or D, the Spy Guy? What show's opening sequence started with a shadowy flight into the world of a man who does not exist?
Sunday Puppet Show.
Was it A, Automan, B, Knight Rider, C, the A-Team, or D, the Spy Guy?
Knight Rider.
David Hasselhoff for the win.
Gotta
love the Hoff.
Don't hassle that Hoff.
Don't hassle the Hoff.
Always hassle the Hoff.
All right. A lot of people saying B, Knight Rider. A few people saying D, the Spy Guy. What do they say in the channel, Point? Yeah,
they are saying B, 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 a D, a B. I watched Knight Rider.
And it is Knight Rider, yes. Yep, it started out with the word Knight Rider, and then they told you he was a shadowy flight into a world of a man who does not exist.
Piece of trivia, the guy who played Kit never even met David Hasselhoff until a rap party for season one.
Oh. All right, where does this line come from? You want to go where everybody knows your name.
The guy who played Kit.
Prison!
Oh, no, I know this one.
Yeah, yeah. You want to go where everybody knows your name.
Penitentiary.
Was this A, Growing Pains?
I know this one.
B, Punky Brewster?
The Woodshed.
C, Cheers? Or D, Who's the Boss? And no, it is not the Applebee's commercial.
Hey, Zeno.
Well, they know your name because no one goes to Applebee's.
Right. All right. Almost everybody
you're
is saying
the one customer.
Cheers. Almost everybody's saying cheers. We have one person saying D, who's the boss. And
hey,
does our
Sibber.
Chat agree?
Sibber's in chat agree? In the lounge. Hey, Sibber.
Hi, Sibber.
Hello. Hey.
All right. Well, all of you guys that said cheers, you are correct.
Sibber, we want to go see the Jackass movie over the weekend. You should join us.
Yay.
All right. Now, number four, here's the beginning line. This is the beginning line of what television show? Here we are, face to face. Here we are, face to face. Was this from A, The Facts of Life?
Grindr.
B, Silver Spoons. D, Head of the Class. Or D, 227.
Here we are, face to face.
Face.
A couple of 227s.
Was it A, The Facts of Life?
These are way over my head.
B, Silver Spoon. D, End of the Class. Face,
a couple of Facts of Life.
Silver Spoons, because that's the only one I never watched.
All right. Well, we have a pretty even. We have a good split across lots of things. Yeah. A. Some people saying A, Facts of Life. Some people saying Silver Spoons. Some people saying Head of the Class. A couple of people saying 227. What does our chat think? Or Poink?
Well, I might have this one.
Again, I got to reset because my cloud
okay.
is choking.
So the channel is saying pretty much C across the board. Or no, we're getting some B, C.
Well, the Blood says B. T'Challa says C.
Why don't you sing the song again? What is the line?
Here we are, face to face, a couple of
silver spoons,
bitches.
That's right, is with that Ricky Schroeder. Yep, that's exactly how it goes. Bitches and all. All right. Ooh. All right, let's see if you know your Saturday morning cartoon theme.
Oh, now we're talking my language.
Some come join our jubilee. The cats are great, they all agree. Did this come from A, Shirt Tales, B, Garfield and Friends, C, Heathcliff, or D, the Tom and Jerry Kids?
Now I don't know what this one is.
Repeat the line, please. Oh.
So come join our jubilee. The cats are great, they all agree.
I know the show.
So is it from A, Shirt Tales, B, Garfield and Friends, C, Heathcliff, or D, the Tom and Jerry Kids? Tom and Jerry Kids Hour, actually.
I remember Shirt Tales. That was a cute show.
Yeah. Doing! The raccoon was really cute. And the little mole.
Did they wear pants?
No, they did not.
They
wore
t-shirts. Shirts.
T-shirts had little tags on. All right.
Porky Pig and it was just a thing back then.
Pants tails. Yeah. So I don't see if anybody is on Shirt Tales. We have quite a few people saying Garfield and Friends, a number of people saying Heathcliff, and a couple of people saying Tom and Jerry Kids. Does our chat have any input?
Our chat is saying
C. They're all Spanish.
That's it.
And that's it. It was Heathcliff and the Cadillac Cats.
Baloo
yep,
says
cats
C. Sherry says C.
Have fun.
Max
playing
says
pranks
C.
on everyone.
And Secret yep. says
I couldn't remember the rest of the.
And that is actually one of my favorite theme songs from 80s cartoons.
Can you sing
just,
it? Sing it. Sing it.
Heathcliff, no one should terrify the neighborhood. But Heathcliff just won't be. Yep, but Heathcliff just won't be undone. Playing pranks on everyone.
Yeah,
all right.
Yeah.
What TV show had a song that said, "We're truly, truly, truly outrageous"? Was it A, She-Ra, B, Beverly Hills Teens, C, Jim and the Holograms, or D, Galaxy High School?
No, I'm staying put.
Yeah, I'm staying here.
They were truly, truly, truly outrageous.
I think I remember
I think I remember hearing the gems and the holograms.
Even, Family Guy was making fun of this song.
I don't think it's gem, what? Because yeah. It was gem that was outrageous, not the holograms.
All right. Yeah.
I like the movie and the original TV show.
Yeah. So we have a couple people on A for She-Ra, one person on Beverly Hills Teens, bunch of people on Gem and the Holograms, and D has one person in Galaxy High School. Anybody in the chat agree with any of them, Point?
They are saying...
Nothing. I got Rescuer saying never watched any of them. Rocket says nothing.
Don't worry, yeah, not a big loss.
No one's guessing.
Alright, this one was Gem and the Holograms.
And this is a show I watched. I actually watched Gem and the Holograms. I don't know why. I don't know why. I just did.
Those misfits were all making mischief.
I think it was the song. I think it was the theme song that hooked me to it.
Alright, how about this one? Watch out, because here we come. It's been a while, but we're back in style.
Here we come.
So was this the new Flintstones Comedy Hour? The Tom and Jerry Show, Alvin and the Chipmunks, or Yogi's Gang? Watch out, because here we come. It's been a while, but we're back in style.
I think I know this one.
Alvin and the Chipmunks.
I do.
I'm thinking it's Alvin and the Chipmunks.
Sounds familiar.
Yeah.
You've heard this. M-U-N-K.
I'm saying C because most of the answers are C.
Here we go. Yeah. All right, so most people in the chat are saying C?
Yep.
All right, and most people in the Chaos Lounge are also saying C, because here we come. That's right. It is Alvin and the Chipmunks. Yep.
I remember that song just now. I had put it. That was in a little cube in my inside-out memory banks, like long-term memory. And now it just fell into the pit of forgetfulness, and I don't know what you're just talking about.
Now, this one was a gimme, so I wanted everybody to have one that they would all get. Thank you for being a friend. Travel down the road and back again.
Oh.
Where did this come from? Was this from Mama's Family?
Star Wars.
B, Head of the Class. D, Saved by the Bell. Or C, Saved by the Bell. Or D, The Golden Girls.
Oh, everyone should love this.
Yes. Thank you for being a friend. Travel down the road and back again. Your heart is true. You're a pal and a confidant.
Dun, dun, dun.
All right. Looks like everybody is going for
everyone's saying Golden Girls. You know what?
They are all.
And you know what? On Betty White's birthday, if you Googled the name Betty White, a graphic faded into your screen saying thank you for being a friend. Wasn't that sweet of Google?
That was.
Yeah.
All right.
Now, that's my dog. Roommate's coming
bark,
home.
Bark, bark!
I have a question for Kevin.
Bark! I'm talking, do you mind?
We have a few more questions, and then you can ask your questions to me.
That's Matt.
Lyric number 9. I know my parents love me. Stand behind me come what may. Was that from A, A Different World?
Totally.
B, the Harper Valley PTA? C, Different Strokes? Or D, Growing Pains?
Star Wars.
I'm gonna say Growing Pains.
Enough with the Star Wars!
I know my parents love me. Stand behind me come what may.
Loki.
A, Different World. B, Harper Valley PTA. C, Different Strokes. And D, Growing Pains. What does our chat say, Point or Mutt?
T'Challa says B.
I'm just gonna stay here.
They place without
I'm gonna go over here.
Okay. All right, so we have a few people saying A. Most people saying D, Growing Pains.
Babs went over to A. Babs is on A. Thea is on A. Fur Demon's on D. Fred Betterhead and Lewis are on D, and so is Zelno.
Yep.
Campion's on D. Bungie's on D. And Sibber is on D, as well as Coaster.
Okay.
And
well,
I think, Shortcake.
Yep. If you ever watched the spinoff of The Cosby Show, you would know that this is A Different World, starring Lisa Bonet.
So it was D?
She went to college. It was A.
It was A. That means Babs and Thea get it.
They got it.
You got to split the winning.
All right.
Nice. You got to split the $1,000 prize.
Here's now number 10 is pretty obscure, but it is actually a very 80s show. The line from the show is, "She's a miracle, and I'll grant you she'll enchant you at first sight." She's a miracle, and I'll grant you, she'll enchant you at first sight. Was this A, Punky Brewster? B, Small Wonder? C, Gloria?
Oh my God.
Or D, Highway to Heaven?
I despised Small Wonder. Made me mad. It was such a bad show. It made me, it taught me anger as a child.
I can feel your anger from here, dude.
Oh my God, it offended me.
It was a bad one.
All right. So awful.
So just about everybody is on Small Wonder. Thea, are you on Highway to Heaven?
No, there were better things to watch at the time.
I would rather watch The Wall than watch Small Wonder.
All right. Well, everybody, it was Small Wonder. One of the most infamous of 1980s.
I want to find her and I want to punch her and go to jail for the night.
Let's
see if she's
still around.
Yeah. I want to find her.
We have 10 left, but these are not multiple choice. I'm going to read you 3 clues. You have to identify who this character is.
Totally worth it.
All right? Clues number 1.
Okay.
British, eye patch, and rodent. British, eye patch, rodent.
Danger Mouse.
I'm here, Danger Mouse.
Go, Ezra. Bring in the content tonight.
Very cool. Was Danger Mouse one of my favorite cartoons? All right, number 2.
When I heard eye patch and mouse, I knew it had to be it.
Yeah. All right. How about number 2?
But what show was Danger Mouse on? Danger Mouse was part of a show.
It
was Danger Mouse. It was his own show.
Oh, I thought he was part of a show.
No. Well, he did crossovers with another show called Duckula.
Duckula. Yep. Well, Duckula came off of him. Okay. Number 2. Muscular, evil, and Snake Mountain.
Muscular,
evil, and
I think you mean Mosquitor.
Skeletor.
Cobra Commander.
I couldn't hear the entire thing. To me,
yeah, what was the last one?
It was Muscular, evil, and Snake Mountain.
Skeletor.
Yeah,
Skeletor.
I think Skeletor.
Obviously Skeletor.
It is Skeletor.
Overblood said Skeletor.
Yeah, so one of the wackiest villains. One of the wackiest villains I've ever seen. He and Yzma should get together. They're like my 2 favorite villains. All right, number 3. Superhero.
Means.
Here we go. Superhero. Goggles. Flexible.
Oh, Jesus.
Plastic Man.
Yeah, it was Plastic Man. Plastic
Man. Very good. Super Friends.
Yeah, I remember that. All right.
He had his own show in the early 80s.
Okay, how about this one? Number 4. Laser, robot, leader. Laser, actually laser gun.
Transformers?
Robot. And leader, who?
Or Megatron.
Well, that could be anybody. That could, I'm thinking either RoboCop, Optimus Prime, leader
Megatron.
One. If you really wanted to get Megatron. Technical, that could, you know, the leader of one of the GoBots.
Ew. I'm surprised.
It was? Yeah, it was actually Megatron because he turned into a laser gun. That was the reason why
GoBots was such a Transformers ripoff.
Yeah. Yes. All right. How about number 5? Wealthy.
GoBots was just a car with a head.
Yep. Wealthy. Child. Dollarmation.
Richie Rich.
Yeah, very good.
How do you pronounce his name, Shortcake?
Witchy Witch.
That's adorable. That's so cute. Okay, handle it.
You're picking on her.
No, she's adorable. That was lovable.
I mean, I do find it very cute myself too.
It's adorable.
I mean, if I would love to have a girlfriend that spoke like her. She would.
All right.
I actually agree. It's adorable as hell. I love your accent.
Next question, please.
But I am way too dirty of an old man for her.
Here comes the next question.
He's literally naked.
Yeah, next clue. Who am I? Who am I? Jungle, elephant, king,
Babar,
Colonel Harvey.
I don't know.
Yeah, Dabar.
Dabar.
Tarzan.
It was Dabar. Point got it right away. God, I hated that show.
It's been like so long since I...
Yep.
Wait, there was a show, saw that, right?
Yep. I've got two more for you. Next one is Artist. Blue. Bouncy. Artist. Blue. And Bouncy. Remember, this is from...
Gusto Gummy.
Ah, somebody got it.
Rob Paulson's voice.
Yes, Rob Paulson's voice. I specifically chose that one because Mutt used to love talking about Gusto Gummy.
I love the gummy bears forever. Gummy bears forever.
All right.
I knew as soon as he said that was Mutt's choice.
Okay.
I need to watch that show at some point.
Next one.
I just hated the way the series ended. We'll rant about it later.
Yeah. Blue. Glasses. Know-it-all. Blue.
Ray Smurf or Ray Simon Simon.
Brainy Smurf.
It was Brainy Smurf.
Well, yeah, the blue eyes, I guess.
Yeah, it was Brainy Smurf. He was the know-it-all. Abadi-abadi. One of the ones I was... Yeah, this is true. He wore... Yep, he did wear a blue sweater.
But wasn't Smurf only...
Simon. All right.
Chatty, no? Right.
Here's a bonus.
Yeah, he wasn't smart. He was a know-it-all.
Yeah.
He was genius.
Yep. Okay, so here's your bonus one.
Yeah, okay, you're right.
Yeah. Here's your bonus. Armageddon. Sword. Loincloth.
He-Man.
He-Man.
Actually, I'm gonna take one of those instead of sword. Armageddon. Yeah.
Sun sword.
Sun sword is what it would have been.
Sun sword. I knew you were going there. Thundar.
It was Thundar. Yes.
How'd I know that? Because Ookla wore a loincloth.
We got tricked.
All right. Well,
such a Star Wars ripoff.
Those are all the ones that I had.
I can throw a couple in there.
Right, hold on. What was your question for me?
Who?
Somebody had
The voice of Garfield. What voice did he play in a show before that where you never seen him?
Oh, I know this one.
Well, it depends. Are you talking about the film Twice Upon a Time? Because he was the voice of Ralph the All-Purpose Animal.
It was a TV show.
It was Lorenzo Music. TV show.
About live action. You only heard him over a speakerphone.
Carlton the Doorman.
Yeah.
What was the name of the show?
I'm trying to remember.
Nope. Rhoda.
Rhoda.
Rona. Rona or Rhoda?
No, Rhoda. It was a spin-off of Mary Tyler Moore.
Right.
Yeah. It was Rhoda.
And the other question is the, what's his name? The, what's that? The Mike Myers plays.
Rishuri and Sachal got it right. We're old.
What's that one that he plays the spy, Mike Myers?
I mean, technically, I remember it, but I've kind of done my homework because he plays my favorite cartoon character, so.
In Austin Power, why do they play that music for the beginning of the movie?
Why? There's a reason? Soul Bossa Nova.
Why do they play Soul Bossa Nova?
I didn't know there was a reason.
You know why?
I don't know why.
It was so that we had a skit for Anthrocon 2001.
they predicted it?
Exactly. Mike Myers lived in Scarborough, Ontario, near Toronto, and he grew up watching a show that I watched too called Definition, and they used the same theme song for the opening of that game show.
Really?
That's why he picked it.
Huh. Well, there you go.
Well, I mean, cool. I remember that show. In fact, that's when I first heard it, and I didn't know it was for anything else, but... Yeah,
I knew it was a game
really
show.
Little. It came on just before, Super Friends or something, like, way back in the early 80s. But I remember the do-do-do-do-do for Definition.
I just thought it was a song.
My aunt was even on that show.
It was a Canadian show, though, wasn't it? Machine. I thought it was a Canadian show, wasn't it?
Yes.
Yeah, okay.
So I've never heard of it anywhere else.
Yeah, it had the same guy. It had some guy from a game show in the States that he was on there, too.
It's like what happened with the Mission Impossible main theme that is not the original creation, but is based on another song that existed before, but
okay,
people always
got?
Related with Mission Impossible now.
Yeah, does anyone in our Mixcloud chat have a question they'd like to throw out?
I've got a few for you.
All right.
Okay. All right. One is specifically for Mutt, but the first two are for everybody.
People always listen to
Marjorie,
and they think,
Doc,
oh, Mission Impossible.
Doozer.
Marjorie, Doc.
Yeah, Fraggle Rock.
Doozer, Fraggle Rock.
Yeah.
Oh, Fraggle.
Which just got rebooted, by the way.
Yeah. So.
Okay. Try this one. Snorkel, Ocean, All-Star.
The Snorks.
The Snorks.
Yeah.
Wait, what was the first one?
All-Star. With the Snorks.
Snorks. And this one is aimed at Herbie only. No one else there will get it.
Okay.
Vomitus, Putrid, Hycockalorum.
Oh, stupid. Water babies.
I hate that friggin' movie.
Water goddamn babies.
There's one movie I hope I never see again in my life. It's that one.
Beat those children.
I have trivia about the Snorks.
Well,
please.
We got. I've, no, I've got. I've got video.
He's got videos to do.
I think I may have found
that
National Harbor.
Me of Final Destination.
So Poink, why aren't you in VR chat now that you're, you know, your wife is in VR chat?
Yeah.
You got.
I'm busy.
Oh, see, that wasn't your excuse before. You said, I'm not going to do VR chat because Babs isn't in VR chat. Now I see
I said
her.
She was going to go first. I played with it, didn't like it.
But you got to go into those virtual worlds and you got to get the vibrating eggs and all that stuff.
The wow. No. What are we getting?
But I think I found the National Harbor they're at there, Mike.
I know.
It looks like it is in. Washington, D.C.?
I bet the weather is gorgeous right now for that because it's so cold.
It was freezing last weekend.
It was perfect for first sitting.
Nice.
Absolutely perfect.
If there was a roller coaster that went around the United States, would you ride it?
Yeah.
It'd be a long drive.
You would die.
That would take a while.
Well, I would need to pack a lunch.
But I mean, no, it would be like...
That would take about a week.
Yeah, it'd be like 48 hours.
Yeah, that would take about a week. We would need breaks and snacks. And I got to bring up. Who is eating the microphone?
Me.
Okay.
No, that was me. I'm sorry. I had a little piece of bread.
Oh,
he's crying. There he is.
He's not good. He's just on the chair.
Now, you need a more attractive avatar for the cameraman because right now it's just a guy in a tux, right?
Yeah, we got to make it a.
You need something more cute because.
I
Lewis.
Thought you were talking about him, but I'm like, no, he's
we gotta give Lewis a reason to be here.
No, you're cute as shit. No, we're talking about the Yappy.
Now, you've seen Yappy's avatar, right, Lewis?
Yeah, I was watching him do Beat Saber last night, and okay. I was lusting.
You were lusting. Have you touched yourself looking at him? Maybe.
I don't want to make him feel uncomfortable.
He's curious.
He's like,
I don't know. He looks pretty happy about it.
It's like, wear off your somebody's reason the jerk off.
You've made someone extra happy down there.
A happy yappy.
He's a happy yappy.
He's a happy yappy.
So how's your week? How you doing? We haven't done a game with him yet. Yes, we have. We did the game with him last week.
Yeah, but you know, I found out he's an artist, so he's probably got like commissions and stuff.
Oh, you do porn?
Do you do music?
Ooh. No, he does art, like hand art.
No, I do 2D stuff.
Okay,
do you do porn?
I do porn. Of course, that's what pays the bills.
We would like a new logo.
Sweet.
Oh,
actually, we need to update our logo with some new characters. We need to do some artwork around.
You know what I need to do? I need to get a new logo so that I can put it in with an advertisement banner and pay to have it put into the Fur Hub. Because there is a lot of people that go through that Fur Hub.
There you go.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
And we can make
French girls.
There you go. So we might have some work for you.
Well, wait a second. Where do people see your art? I mean, I gotta see what kind of work you do. So I gotta see if I have to take some money out of my wallet.
I have a safer work one. I can write the Twitter of.
Fuck that! Show
I
us the penis.
I also have another one. Probably not.
Don't mind Toxie. He's just being Toxie.
What? Yeah. What are you? I.
Dog.
What? No. What did you just say? No. I'm not a
No one dislikes penises.
Who the hell's tied up in the corner? I thought he was somebody tied up. I thought he had rope.
Hey, user.
Like, where did we get rope?
We're going to call him 38, right? That's her name? 38? Username 38?
Username 038. Yeah, that's the Steam name.
Okay, 38. Good to see you. All right. Oh, we've got a web page going here.
I can't figure out what that says.
Oh, wow. Yeah, you're an artist because we can't understand those words.
K-I-G.
Look at that. Oh, my God. You want to
try that again?
Our pins get out of sync if you're not looking at him. So as soon as the camera looked away.
There you go. Now it's better. Okay.
I've messaged Cooper Tom to see if he would help maybe build a world for us to replace this piece of shit world that we're in now.
And what do you say?
He hasn't responded yet.
What's wrong with this one?
It sucks. Especially if you're the first person. If you're the first person in the room, it will blow up and you go laggy as hell.
Mm. Oh yeah, that happens to me.
If you're the leader.
Oh, in 10 minutes we're gonna play our adult game because it'll be 9 o'clock.
Okay, is that a K?
Oh, penises.
Yay. But we need more questions.
K I G A I.
H-O-L-T, and then the number 7.
You move the camera over. You can't see the camera.
I was assuming I have.
Gotcha.
Do a screenshot.
Be straight on to see it.
There you go. Okay.
Make sure the little cutie's there, too.
Sorry, gotta reset again.
Nice. So in about 10 minutes, we're gonna do the adult game. We need additional questions from our chat, so please help us out. I've got 5. Toxie, we need you to come up with a couple of questions. Multiple choice.
There's a bug on the wall.
What happened?
Okay.
Kill it.
That's a camera.
I don't know. Yeah. What is that?
Yeah, questions like how many times a yappy fart
what is
in
a camera?
Day?
Something along that line.
H-O-L-T.
Get the uppies button.
Yay!
That was put
uppies.
There for you.
Yeah. I love it.
Yeah, but you don't use it anymore because Toxie's not here.
Well, Toxie will probably be jumping back in. No, he's here now. So, but he could always jump into the lounge from the living room. Mm-hmm. He did that before.
You got mini. Desktop.
Yeah.
No, not in desktop. We can do the full.
I had a weird dream that we defeated a demon and Toxie took his magic wand and he was going to be the next emperor of the world and make it all furry.
Yeah, that's something I would do. If I ever, like, legitimately found, like, a genie or was given, like, you get 3 wishes. What is your wish? It's like, I wish all furries could be their Sona.
Oh.
Do something global that changes the whole world.
Now, Lewis, I'm on your Twitter, but I'm just seeing a bunch of retweets. I'm trying to find your arts.
Well, that's unfortunate. Look on the media page.
Yeah, I was going to say, click media.
Scroll.
Oh, is that a thing? Oh, look at that.
Yeah, that's a thing.
Show it on stream.
I see a map of BLC.
BLFC.
Two posts down.
2 posts down.
Okay, then you start seeing art.
Definitely can do snowboarding for about 6 months out there.
So that's his Twitter, so you can watch and see if he opens up so that you can go get your porn.
And who did your avatar?
Porn!
Yeah. This, the avatar that I'm wearing right now in VRC is Bubblegum Bark.
Bubblegum Bark. And that's who made it?
I just recolored it.
Okay.
Yeah, Bubblegum Bark made this base. In fact, they have like a public version of it at Fur Hub that you can try out. But I liked it so much, I went and bought it and recolored it as me.
I might have to buy that thing.
I'm going to have to get one so Yappy will talk to me.
Wow.
So Yappy, while
we have
him
he won't log off as soon
there.
As I get into VR chat. Yes. Say, hey, Yappy's online. He just logged off.
It's a good thing for notifications. I can like, you've got to skedaddle.
I'm still here. I was going to ask Yappy, before we lose our artist.
I got a game for you.
Okay, hang on 1 second.
I got a game for Megaplex you can do.
Okay,
we don't do Megaplex. We're not doing Megaplex anymore.
Yep.
FPS will never be at Megaplex again.
There's been problems.
And not at Anthrocon either.
Yeah, there's been sadness in the ranks.
So FPS probably will not be at another con ever.
Yeah, it's gotten sour.
No,
it's
I'm just saying that whoever runs the con... For your fursuit games.
Yeah, that's not us anymore.
We're not involved.
Sorry, Fred. Right, good idea, though, I'm sure.
That's okay. But while our artist friend is still there before he leaves.
He's writing on the wall.
Yeah. Can you go to my Twitter feed? I actually got a piece of artwork. I want to get his opinion of this piece of artwork.
Right.
I never get artwork, but I was really impressed with this.
I don't know. I don't know when the last time I had artwork.
This young lady is from China. And I just kind of like happened upon her while she was like posting some artwork, and I thought it was really amazing. And so I got a piece of artwork from her.
I see that Sharjuan is a guest of honor this year at Anthrocon. Sharjuan sounds like spaghetti.
Yes, he is coming to Anthrocon again this year.
As a guest of honor. Is that a repeat guest of honor, or was he just a performing guest before?
He's a special guest. He's special guest. But anyway, so do you see the little
that one? That is so cool.
No, that ass right there.
Yeah, I thought she might get a kick out of it. Like I said, she does stuff that's very stylized, but she also does she does all of the lantern core.
Beautiful.
So
artwork.
She knows what. Yeah. And she kind of did take
the lighting
in a very
is absolutely
style.
Fantastic. I love it.
Look, you can pinch your own butt right now if you just reach forward and pinch.
All of them. It's an infinite loop now.
I'm gonna go back in my corner.
go to your corner. You're starting trouble.
All right. So if anybody else has artists,
o'clock.
Yeah, I was gonna say if anybody else has artists that they feel they got a piece.
Hey, but.
Alrighty. Alright, it is time to guess the answer. We're going to give you a multiple choice and see if you know what it is. And it's after 9 o'clock, so please send your children to bed.
Yes. All children, go away.
Alright. First question.
Puppet after dark.
Puppet after dark. How long is the world's longest penis?
Ooh, I know this.
Is it A, 10 inches, 0.5, 10 and a half inches?
Oh, yeah, this is definitely after dark.
This is after dark. 10 and a half inches, or B, 12 inches, or C, 13.5 inches, or D, 15.25 inches, human. Human being.
Are you talking for people or for what?
For a person. For a human being. A human male.
Probably goes.
Looking for a human male. So again, A, 10 and a half inches. B, 12 inches. C, 13.5
no, I'm only 5 inches.
Inches.
We talked about this last week.
Or
I'm only 5 inches.
D, 15.25 inches.
That is quite famous in Mexico for getting put on unemployment. And
his
gets money
the
from
python.
Because his dick is too big to work.
All right.
For him to go to work. Yeah. It works just fine. But his penis is too big for him to go to get a job anywhere.
All right. Rio says D. Mephita says D. Rhino says 18 inches. Secret says C. Captain Roo says D. Rio says give me the D. Canis says E. Matt Wolf said C. And Canis also C, 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 and C. All right. The answer is C. 13.5 inches by a gentleman named John Falcon. His penis was measured at 13.5 inches when it was erect and has an 8-inch diameter.
Diameter of 8
inches? Diameter of 8 inches.
I think the record's not 8.
You can do nothing with that. There's nothing you can do with that.
No, actually, I think the record's actually been...
Well, I know guys that can take that.
There's someone in Mexico with an 18-inch.
From one side to the other side.
All right, what is the average size?
Are you talking about me? Oh, thank you.
There you go. Now, what is the, since we're,
yeah,
now we did the human
big.
Side, now we're going to do the animal side. What's
oh,
the
no.
average size of a horse penis?
Why?
Average
no.
size of a horse penis.
Okay.
Is it A?
We got people oh can't know. Why
what?
Are we going here?
Okay. We just asked human penis. This is a question. We're curious.
Oh, the horse cock.
I can see it now.
What
we're going to get canceled for being freaking bestiality zoophiles.
Oh my god.
This is, we're not talking about humping
yeah,
it.
You are reinforcing the bad stereotype.
Should we not do this question? Alright, we're moving on.
I'm here.
The answer
I
is
say we did.
20 inches. Alright.
Exactly.
The largest orgy.
20 inches.
The largest orgy in the world had how many people in it?
Would it be the chaos? Look at Yama's leaving. He's leaving. You just pissed off Yama because you're getting dirty.
Did he leave?
Are you leaving, Yama?
No.
I will stop. All right, never mind. We're stopping. All right, moving on. The game is over. Thank you for playing. I hope you enjoyed it. All right, and I ruined the show. Never mind. I thought it was going to be funny.
I thought this was all for Oni's after show.
Never mind.
Even then, it's
like, ooh, are you gone, Yama? Did you split? Oh, I think you really split. Okay, someone pick it up.
You guys want to play?
Yeah, see, even
I screwed it up.
Even El Dorado is yelling at us.
I thought it was. They was on a talk show earlier, and everyone was getting a kick out of the weird questions. It was awkward.
On a talk show? Where? That's not radio safe.
Yeah, it is.
How big is your penis?
It was a walrus ball.
I have shame. I have such severe shame.
You have brought great dishonor to your family.
Oh my god, someone page Yama and tell him to come back in.
Don't worry.
Yama is gone.
Yama's gone. Does anyone have Yama on text?
You have dishonored Yama.
I think I actually have him on text.
You have dishonored the family.
Yes, you have brought great dishonor to the family.
He had sensitive bunny ears. You know, those ears are so big. They when porn hits him, it just explodes his mind.
Oh, yeah. Oh.
Like Thea. Poor Thea with those big ears that he has.
Oh yeah, look at the sensitive.
Those would absorb porn so bad, his little head would explode.
Talk about umox.
Ears.
Yeah, umox. Umox.
Look at those hips.
Oh me.
Tail. Oh shit, Oni's here.
Ah.
Yeah.
Oni.
Hey Oni.
Were your ears burning?
Yeah, my ears are burning. Like, somebody's talking about me.
Who? Yeah, I was literally just talking shit about you a few moments ago.
Oh, I guess point disappeared.
Point split. Everyone left.
Oh God, we started talking.
So you drove point away. Of all people to drive away, you drove point off.
I don't think.
I think more so he drove point to insanity.
No, I think point just had to go to the bathroom.
No, to sanity.
We broke point.
So is your after show for all the dirty stuff, Oni? I mean, can everybody talk about their wee-wees in there?
It's mature, so.
Yeah. I have a question.
I do have a question for everybody in the Chaos Lounge.
We were learning fun facts about animals.
How many people in the Chaos Lounge have been playing Wordle?
Wordle? I love Portal.
Wordle.
What the fuck is Wordle?
There's the mirror, Eldorado. Yeah. And look it, I am a very sexy camera.
Oh god.
Oh yeah, baby. Oh yeah, baby. Look at my f-stop. Oh, my f-stop is so big.
Werewolf pushes buttons.
I am an f8, baby. Ooh yeah. And my ISO is 1,000. I'm a whole 1,000 ISO. And I run at 24 frames a second.
Oh, baby, when I'm through with you, you'll be going at 48 frames a second.
You gotta see what develops.
So KP, you were asking what? A Wordle?
I was asking about Wordle. Yeah, it's like it's been going on for, you know, the better part of a year, but it's really, really caught on in the last couple of months.
Online game, yeah.
I'm just wondering how many people have been playing Wordle, how many people are keeping up with it. What are your strategies since you only have 6 moves? Okay, so for those that do not know, Wordle is a game that you do not have to subscribe to.
Post on Twitter about it.
Yeah, it is a game. It's a word game, and it's kind of like a game called Lingo, L-I-N-G-O, where you have a 5-letter word. And there are no clues, no anything. You just guess a word. It will show you if you have any letters in the correct position or if you have correct letters in the wrong position. So when you press enter, if it turns green, the letter is correct and in the right place. If it turns yellow, then the letter is in the word, but it's not in the right spot. And you have six. Yeah. You have six tries like to figure out what the
like
word
the
is every day.
Game.
Yeah, exactly. It's mastermind with words.
It's like Sudoku. I never got into Sudoku
letters,
either.
Yeah, gray letters are they're not in the word at all. They stay gray.
Why did the Chaos Lounge video die?
It looks. I don't know. But yeah, Wordle has been getting like a.
It's working for being looted.
For me.
Yeah. But the thing is, like, this game was this game was introduced by a guy named, I believe, Woodle was his last name, and he and his wife liked to play word games, and so he just wrote this little easy peasy game, very simple game, and it caught on, and he decided not to try to monetize it. And he just said, if anybody wants to play it, you can play it once per day, and then you have to wait until the beginning of the next day, and you'll get a new word. So you can't just play ad infinitum. And there are, like, I follow Linda Carter, the lady from Wonder Woman, and she is, like, also really into it. She plays it every day, and she posts what her score is, and she'll say, oh, I got this one in three tries. I feel so good. And then if she didn't get one, she's like, well, you know, I'll just try tomorrow.
I'll kill everyone.
No, she's one of the ones that doesn't take it super seriously, but she loves to play it.
I'll cancel this game!
I love watching Linda Carter speak.
So
she's
why
really...
is Lewis walking on the walls? Why are you walking up on the edge of the walls?
I'm trying to be sexy.
Because I can.
Games for sure.
Don't go tinkling off the wall. You'll get everybody wet.
Actually, I can't. It kicked me out.
Go turn on the uppies!
So that was the only reason I brought it up. We used to talk about all kinds of internet fads and stuff, and Wordle is a pretty big fad right now. It's a pretty big thing.
Mm-hmm.
So I just want to make sure we talk about it. If anybody plays it.
I think I got to delete uppies. I think uppies is what's crashing the world.
No, uppies stays.
No.
No, you don't get rid of uppies.
I think uppie is what's breaking.
Then you get back in here.
I will come back in there.
Eldorado wants Lewis to tinkle off the balcony.
We just
you either come back or you
world.
Come on your back.
We'll make a new lounge with oh blackjack.
No.
And hookers.
No.
And hookers.
Oh, so basically Vegas.
Call it the fur pile lounge.
No, fuck backlash. We're gonna just make a straight up sex lounge, and it's gonna be a themed.
We got it. We got to tone it back, guys. We got to tone it back. Honestly, yeah. Let's just grab the reins.
It'll be like Dante's Inferno. The deeper you go, the more crazy you get. And at the very bottom, there's...
Bring it back to PG-13. Lose the R. We gotta bring it back to PG-13.
At the very bottom, there's just a screen that's showing the episode.
Berg, even pick him up. Pick each other up.
Oh, yes.
The comments aren't just from my game. It's been from a lot of the night.
If I stand in this position and you put your hands down there, can you pull me from...
Take it back.
Pick each other up.
Arc.
Oink.
Oh yeah.
He did it.
Yep.
Yeah, I hear they're supposed to be doing a new album.
He's just pulling.
Okay. Raise your hand if you know the answer to these. The screen is off. What happened?
I think that it's crashed and burned in there for some reason.
And also, if you know the answer in the Mixcloud chat, just throw it out there. Okay, the first question is, what is the first fast food restaurant that was founded first? What fast food restaurant was founded first? If you know the answer, raise your hand or just shout it out.
Oh, I got to turn the audio on. Hold on.
Yeah, what helps?
Dare I say shout it out loud?
McDonald's
was 1950s, but I think there was something in the late 1940s.
Oh, there were plenty of stuff before McDonald's.
Oh, yeah.
I'll give you a date. 1948 was the year it was founded.
It may be something like crystals.
It could even be KFC.
Eldorado says Wendy's.
No, Wendy's is 69.
Shire Black says McDonald's. White Castle from Rosario.
It might be White Castle. That sucked.
Ollie Copperworth might be onto something.
What?
It may have been something like Coney Island, the hot dogs, Nathan's or something.
Okay. Hmm.
Hmm. My reference is a page called Thought Catalog.
Okay.
White Manna. Campion says the right answer. It is In-N-Out Burger. Believe it or not, 1948.
Oh.
In one,
wow. In-N-Out Burger was founded in 1948.
Okay. Well,
I'm looking at your page now, and it disagrees with you.
Okay.
Oh, yeah, that's right. In and out, it was actually not.
It says June 20th of 1919, the first A&W was opened.
Oh, yes, that's it. It was A&W.
Oh, there we go.
You have to got it. Okay. All right. Well, there you go. That was our trivia game, and I'm like 2 for 2 right now.
Well, let me ask the room, and we can also ask the VR chat this. What was the first fast food that you remember ever having?
I got to respawn.
McDonald's. Oh, gosh. The first one you ever remember?
Yeah, like, where did your parents take you? Mine will surprise you.
Probably McDonald's, honestly. I don't remember.
Oh, hey, they fixed it.
I think ours was probably either Burger King or Jack in the Box.
Believe it or not, mine was Red Lobster.
That's not fast food. That's
not fast it's food. Not cuisine. Yeah.
Wait, no.
It's quick serve, it'll be Jack in the Box.
I would say, guys, that's full table service at Red Lobster.
Yeah, no, that's
you're
like
probably
fancy
right.
Five-star
yeah. So probably it used to be for the little window of time that it was open in Jacksonville, it was Jack in the Box.
You know, yeah. Something like Red Lobster used to be like fine dining.
It still is, is it not?
No.
No.
I've never been there.
It's like, no, Chili's or Applebee's now.
I've never
been. Hey, Shooter, you want to go to the Sizzler?
Oh, fuck. Now I'm...
Do you remember Steak and Ale?
Oh, I love Steak and Ale.
I love their salad bar.
I love the Kensington Club. Oh, my God.
I loved it when Wendy's had a salad bar.
Oh, you're oh, well, yeah, well, I was working for Racks, and they had the...
And now we lost, Sweet Tomatoes.
Oh, yeah, that's...
Yeah.
I like sweet tomatoes.
Yeah, it was good salad.
You know, I was so excited when I was like, yeah, moving back to Florida, I'm definitely going to hit up sweet tomatoes.
Oh, no. Like, what about you, Mutt? You didn't answer. What was your first?
I don't remember.
What was your first what now?
Fast food.
I don't remember.
It was McDonald's for me, yeah.
No, I do remember. No, I do remember when I was little, back in Houston, in my old neighborhood, there was a Whataburger, but before it was a Whataburger, it was a Wiener Schnitzel, and I used to love going there.
Hmm.
Geronimo says Reese's. CC's was the first.
Actually, no. My first fast food was like a chain that was in the South, and I don't think it's around anymore. It was called the Sheik.
I don't remember that one.
It sounds like a strip club.
Who remembers
they
Lums?
They did a bunch of like pita type sandwiches.
Who remembers Lums?
Oh, good lord.
Not me.
Or Frisch's Big Boy.
Oh, I remember the Big Boy, but ours was Kip's Big Boy.
Anybody old enough to remember the drive-in restaurants like A&W where the waitresses were on roller skates?
Yes, except we had
Sonic.
Yeah, we still have them.
We have Sonic that does that.
We had Weber's Root Beer that did that.
Yeah, I remember A&W. A&W did that here.
Saskatchewan.
And then, let's see, Hojo's. Howard Johnson's.
Oh, Howard Johnson's?
Oh,
yeah,
wow.
They were like Denny's.
Howard Johnson.
Yeah, Hojo's.
Eating silver dollar pancakes.
I remember Ground Round.
Who remembers when Woolworths used to sell hot dogs?
I love the Woolworths soda fountain. Oh, it was so awesome.
But they used to, do the hot dogs where they grilled the hot dog bun on the grill
on
and
the grill.
Butter.
Yep.
And the hot dog was like grilled on the grill and butter, and everything was just grilled in butter.
Uh huh.
Where was this?
Woolworths.
Woolworths. Yeah. I used to get BLTs there.
Woolworths or Wilco. There was also Wilco.
Yeah, Wilco. But Woolworths also sold pets. I got my first hamster. At
they did. Like in goldfish and stuff. Yeah.
Wow.
And it bit the hell out of me.
Did you ever use an Automat?
No, automats were before my time.
Yeah, they didn't have any around here.
What's an automat?
Those are those vending
machines. You go in, put a coin in, and it gives you a piece of pie or something like that.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, I think it was the Toronto Hospital had one in one of their
basically
cafeterias.
What there is now is vending machines. It was the early vending machine that actually served hot food. Because people were stocking it from the back all the time. And in the front, people would put their quarters in and take out their Salisbury steak.
or their.
Does anybody remember like Morrison's cafeteria?
Yes.
Yes. Luby's, Morrison's, all but those.
Because those you paid for like by the pound, or you paid for by the dish.
Plate. Yeah. You picked up the individual entrees.
Yeah.
Like
so it's like, oh, the steak is $8, or back then it would have been. The steak is $3. The potatoes are 50 cents. The corn is another 50 cents. The apple pie is $1. The soda, your one trip soda is $1.
Okay, so at those places, who got like the pudding and who got the jello for dessert? Who got the jello?
I got the pudding.
I always went for like pies and cakes. I didn't want the. Because jello was cheap. It's like, screw jello, it's cheap.
Yeah, that's what I was allowed to have.
Even though Yappy made me sick one time on the show eating it through a straw.
I thought that was Simba.
I think it was Simba, and you cheered him on. Also, you want a blast from the past? I had Christmas dinner one day, years and years ago, at the Pick and Save Buffet.
I didn't know they had a buffet.
Like, we're showing the lounge right now. You don't need to puppeteer for this.
Has some things that are very endearing, and it's funny.
Okay,
I like
I'll
it.
Give it a go.
Yeah, but Mutt does know his robots.
Well, I'm a huge Big Hero 6 fan. It's probably my favorite Disney film, so I'm gonna be hard pressed to.
I love the movie. I hated the series.
Oh, everybody's cloning off Lewis now.
But that's not Lewis though. That's another one.
What can I dump?
It must be the public model.
This is a public-based model.
I need to dump something.
Does it do the happy eyes?
If I
coaster?
Dump,
whenever I log into it, I'll have to
I'm not sure how to do it yet.
Try to do happy eyes.
I think I'll dump.
Your tail's all waggly.
Spread!
The tail is bouncy. Very bouncy. It looks like it's wagging.
I wonder how hard it would be to put like a superhero costume, like a Green Lantern Corps or a Blue Lantern Corps on these.
Probably not that hard.
Well,
dude.
Just get Toxie to do it. He's good at this stuff.
There we go.
He'll do it for a fee.
We're multiplying.
Hey, Toxie, you need to make Mutt out of Tatum 2.0.
No.
Join us.
Find the real one.
What's a no?
Doing the werewolf job.
Now see, this is like Lewis is like the leader of all of these clones.
He's like the shiny version.
Yeah, it's like Lewis should come up and lead the pack. Come on, Lewis, you gotta lead the pack.
Funny. Play up. Have one side of the room as the Lewises and the other side of the room as Sheba's.
Yeah, play a march.
Yeah, I'm sure we can find a march.
Do like a parade.
No, I think we need to have a battle between the Sheebas and the Lewises.
Well, do the Imperial Death March.
We
still got it right.
Let's still do music for the day.
There he goes.
Oh. Even the channel agrees.
What?
Imperial Death March.
Yep.
Okay, I think whoever has the flamethrower wins.
Yeah.
What's with the tentacles?
Oh, that's it's a chaos spell.
Oh.
Glad I'm not there.
Actually, you know what would be hilarious? If we did the theme from Speed Racer and all of them were running around just.
Okay, Lewis, get ready to lead it.
No, what have you done?
You can always do the Yakisaka. Everybody know about it.
Yeah.
Of the show.
Oh, the Air Patrol is a question rather droll for to march and drill over field and hill.
Is a military goal.
Is a military goal.
Look at them tits jiggle.
1, 2, 3, 4, dress it up. 2, 3, 4, by the right foot.
Get out of there, poor demon. You're not part of the pack. I'm gonna hide Avatar.
No, you dare!
I really want this clip to put on somewhere where we can download it. This is adorable.
Join us! Join us!
Whenever you are sad, you need to watch this.
This could be my screensaver.
This could be a meme. This should be a meme.
This could be just a wallpaper, actually.
Yeah, I love this.
This could be a wallpaper engine wallpaper. Speaking of which, I need to work on that.
Oh, I love it. Wow.
Yippee. We also attack.
That's how I want it. Purple.
I love the fact that we're all running. They're all running. It's so cute.
What are you doing? Fill the room with dark energy. Use the staff.
They're trying to hug the evil out of them.
Fill the entire world.
I wanted to play the Hot Wheel video, but we fucked it.
By the way, Mutt, I didn't ask.
Use your staff.
Boba Fett this week.
I haven't finished the episode yet. I watched part of it, but I'm really impressed so far.
We'll talk next week.
So, can we do either Yakety Sax or the Speed Racer theme and have them just run in every random direction?
Speed Racer theme.
Oh, or either one, the Yakety Sax.
Yeah, or just do running in the 90s.
And then everybody can run around like crazy, and we will record it, and it will be cute.
Run on like idiots.
Not like idiots. Hey, like
we're already halfway there.
Big fluffy idiots.
The paw pet.
It's big fluffy cutes. Lots of fluffy cutes. Please don't do that. I can't say it out of those eyes.
I don't know what the hell that was.
What have you been listening to, Yappy?
Well, there's another March theme from that I was trying to think of, and I couldn't. That's not it either. Ah, damn.
Far away.
Not what I want.
From worldly cares.
Oh, not what I want.
Just do Perry. Just do Perry and King Clear. You want March music?
It's during the opening sequence of Robin Hood, and they're doing the little parade march. All the little characters are marching along, and it's like. It's part of Wizard's thoughts.
It's hamster dance, isn't it?
Is it?
No,
it's but it's there's that whole music part of it.
It's called Oodalolly, is it?
No, Oodalolly is the second song you hear when you see Robin Hood and Little John.
Do you have the Robin Hood soundtrack?
Yes.
Robin Hood opening theme.
Just try the first track.
Oh, this is the way he whistles it out.
Yeah, but go further in the song.
There it is.
And here we go. And here. He goes, off.
Go to like the middle of the song.
Off. Good girl.
Extended dance remix.
Who's crawling on the floor?
Oh, wow. Really?
All together.
Almost. Because they use it.
We have to find that. I know the part you're talking about.
Yeah.
Thank you.
Toxie knows to start running chaotically. And with the video screens in back, it seems like it's not many more. It looks like it's literally thousands of them in all these different rooms.
Don't make come into the middle here. Surrounded. I'm surrounded by wolves. The hell for a demon? You like ruining it.
Funny. It's funny.
Ring around the appy. Ring around the appy.
Wow. I love fur demons like in the middle, like, this is fine.
Okay, and guys, we're not leaving Mixcloud quite yet. It's going to take some
time
to move over if we do.
Yeah.
Let's see here.
Zodiac, go for it! They have everything that you're meant to enjoy. You can hang out all the boys. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. It's fun to stay at the YMCA. You can get daily.
Lewis is tail spinning his leak spinning his tail. Everyone, leak spin your tail. Turn your back to the camera and leak spin your tail. It almost be like you're all twerking.
I do not know how I should feel right now.
Thank you, Toxie, and also Point for coming in tonight. Thank you, Bunches Gun Kazan, Paul Mitzer, Pickle, Zaldo, Lauren, Brother Rat, Reno, Super Lupus, Captain Floof, Wing King, Odie, Wolf Dog, William Blackwell, Acer M, Nard Dog, Campion Mephitis, Claymore, Blackfoot Fat, Wolfcat Sloppy Wheelie, Fur Demon Lar, and Brother Rat. Again, isn't he in there twice?
You like, said that last week.
What's the other one?
Oh, there is two Brother Rats.
Okay, that's right. we love them twice as much. That's fine. And our PayPal supporters, Matt Wolfwood, Rocket T Coyote. Thank you also for sending in those videos, Rocket T. And who's our other friend who did that? That was, what? Who's the other friend who sent in the videos with the slot machine?
Oh, Chance?
Crunch.
Thank you, Crunch, for sending in your video as well. Thanks all for supporting. Thanks for bringing in the content. We really appreciate that. Makes our job a little bit easier because we're busy. But we love doing this show for you. So everyone have a very
Scrub
safe week.
I want to say thank you to Yama and Scrub Coyote for getting me happy.
Take care, everyone. See you next week.
Bye.
Good night. Sleep tight.
And thank you, Lewis, for being a great support tonight.
Thanks to Rummage. And thanks to the guy on the credits. Nice job.
Thanks for everyone in the Chaos Lounge.